So now he's standing still, like I did the other day. I'm going to ask him to walk before he walks. I want it to be my idea for him to walk. I don't want him to preempt me and walk before I ask him to. And just like the other day, I don't care where he walks to as long as he walks. And if you think about the other day, he didn't venture this far down here. He kind of stayed closer to that end the other day. Right there, he picks up that trot. I'll just bend him around. And right there, when he hit that walk, to me, he felt like he mentally came back down again. So just like the other day, I don't really have to bend him to a complete stop before he relaxes. Right then, all I had to do was bend him to a walk. And when he hit that walk, he was relaxed. And you can see he stayed at that walk right now. And I really like how he's walking right now, so I'm just going to go ahead and ask him to trot. Now, right there, see, as soon as I trotted, he hit that canter again. I'm just going to bend him around, tip all that out, and I might just let him go at the walk there. Just like the other day, I eventually got to where I could bend him to where he walked and I let go. Same thing right there. So I'm going to ask him to trot. So we're trotting. Now this time we've trotted a lot further and he hasn't picked up that canter on his own. So this is more like where he just picks up that canter, I'll just reach down and bend him around real soft. As soon as he hits that trot, I might let go. See right there, I let go and he came back to a walk. So mentally he's a lot more relaxed. There we go, see his head hang down? Mentally he's a lot more relaxed today than he was the other day. And I didn't ride him yesterday. Pick up that trot. Now there's another horse leaving the arena here. Remember the other day he, gets pretty distracted when horses are leaving the arena. So just reach down and bend him around. And just notice when I go to bend him, my hand goes a long way out to the side. You're not pulling back. You're just going to take your hand to the side. And I'm just holding it in my fingertips. I'm not pulling on him. I'm just offering that bend to him. And when he softens and relaxes like that, I'll let go. There you go, he came back to a walk and he's just walking.
I'll ask him to try again. This way for a second.
There we go, that's kind of what I'm looking for right there. Just that relaxed trot where his head hangs down. Like that. There you go, you see we're starting to tip out some of that anxiety. Starting to just stretch that neck down. Just stretch that neck down and relax. Like that. Yeah, see, he's starting to do, and right there he just comes back to a walk. He's starting to relax that neck down just more and more, and see what the walk he's walking, he's got that neck relaxed down. That just tells me that anxiety that he had all built up in there is just slowly tipping out.